The supplies or tools you will need today will be your magnetic rollers, your comb. You can choose to use either your rat tail comb or your styling or cutting comb. Either one of these are correct. You will need some product. If you don't have product, that's okay. Most of you will not. I will be using this liquid styling, this foam. It's kind of like mousse. You could use setting lotion. Either one of these are correct. If you use a setting lotion, make sure to dilute it. You will also use your small silver clips. I will be using the sliding clips today so that the end of the clip does not poke into my rollers or stick out. You will also need your water bottle, your hand sanitizer, and your disinfectant spray. Hey guys, so all week we've been working on doing roller sets. You've watched quite a few videos yesterday, and so today we're just going to get into action. I know a few of you guys have already done this classic style roller set, but I'm here to bring it back for you guys just to refresh your memory. And this is also for the other group, the other half of you guys who have not seen the roller set. I think we started out doing sectioning and that's about it. So today we're going to cover looking at how to do a six section parting, and then also how to roll this wonderful hair in a basic classic style roller set. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get started. Now I did show you at the beginning of the video the tools that we're using. One tool that we're going to start off using is this rat tail comb. I prefer this tool for sectioning, but it ain't the law. I mean, hey, you can use a regular styling comb if you prefer, but for me, I like to use my little rat tail to help out. Also, we're going to be using a variety of different types of magnetic rollers. I'm probably, because of the length of her hair, I might use quite a few different sizes, but what I have here are my tan and my yellow rollers. With that being said, when you think about your roller sets, if the hair wraps around the hair more than 2.5 turns, you're definitely going to get a curl. If it wraps around the hair 1.5 turns, you'll get more of a wave. And if it only wraps around the hair one time, you're going to get what we call a C-shaping. So today we're going for curls. And Miss Janice right here, Miss Janice is going to have a head full of curls, okay? Because I'm working with this tan and this yellow size roller. So before we got started, I went ahead and got my client shampooed and wanted to ensure that her hair was detangled really well before we got started. Once again, like we talked about, you want to make sure that when you are detangling the hair, you are starting from the ends and working your way up. I know Sambia, there was a video with him doing sectioning, and so you guys are kind of, at this point, I'm pretty sure comfortable with doing your sectioning. But for this particular set, we are going to do a six section parting. And what that means is we're going to base it off of the length of the rod. So when I go down, I'm going to do a mohawk, basically a mohawk all the way down from the front hairline to the back of the head, which is what we established was the nape. So I'm going to take my roller. You don't really want to take your roller and measure the width of your subset or of your section the entire length of the roller. You want to give yourself a little bit of grace, a little bit of leeway to work with. So I'm going to come about right here and about right there, and I'm going to measure out the width of this the length of this roller so I can create a section that I'm going to be placing my rollers in. All right, so with that, I'm going to take my roller and place it. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to come about right in here in that center and line it up with the nose. Bring it about right here. And then I'm going to come in here and come on the sides and find out how wide this joker need to be. Okay. Come back over here, bring it back. And then I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Okay. So now I see about how wide it need to be. I'm just going to take those lines and I'm going to extend it from the front hairline all the way to the back of the head. Now granted, we don't always get it right on the first try. I like to go ahead and kind of make a little, pinch the hair a little bit and bring it out of my way. Then I'm gonna do the same thing to the other side. Now I know this is gonna be the first time that a lot of you guys are sectioning the hair. So you might not be able to get it from the front hairline all the way to the back. What you can do to kind of break this up a little bit, you can start, you can stop basically at the apex just to kind of break it up so you can see how wide. Make sure that it's not going like and getting wider and wider. You can kind of control it if you break it up into different subsections, okay? So I'm going to do that since you guys are just getting started. This is your first time. And like I said, a few of you guys have already did this roller set, but some of the rest of you have not. So I'm going to break it down to fit your speed. And I do apologize for getting all up in the camera like that. And I'm just going to continue the same flow. So that will give me a little bit, it's going to break it down and make it a little bit easier for me to work with. Come on, baby girl. And I'm just going to come all the way down to the nape. And I'm going to move that hair out of the way. And I can, if I want to, so that I can kind of peek back here. I notice at the bottom, it's not quite even. So I'm going to come down here and fix it. And we can go back and perfect it later. Right now, I'm really just trying to get a general idea of how wide I want the subsection to be, okay? Yep, so just keep working it. And like I said, you don't have to try to perfect it right now. The goal is just to get a general idea of how wide you need this to be. Okay. So now we have this side over here. It's a big old canvas. Okay, it's too wide to put one roller there. So I'm going to come over here and break this section over here down a little bit more. Now, if I choose to use, I can measure with either roller because both of them are basically the same length. I have two long rollers. So I can use either one of these to measure with. When I start actually going in and creating my subsections, that's when that's going to really matter. So right now, I'm picking up, I can pick up any one of these guys. So I have a section up here at the top. And then I have a section back here in the back, okay? Now I'm going to come over here and I'm going to work on my sides over here. And this is going to tell me a little bit if my middle section is off balance, okay? So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to place this guy right here. And I'm going to measure out how wide this is. Now when you get around to the sides, you're going to kind of curve. What you're trying to do, and let me go back so you guys can see what I just did. When you come here and you get ready to measure, you're going to basically mimic what you see here. When it's dipping in like a C shape in here, I'm going to do the same thing right on this side right here so that it's wide enough from here as well as down here at the bottom. Okay, so when I do that, I'm going to come here, place my roller here, bring my comb. I take my finger, drag it with me, pinch this hair over here and move it out the way. Okay, and now I can comb this forward and bring the rest of the hair back to me so I can divide and section these two pieces up. Now, on this side over here, I can tell you right now, it's too a little, I got a little wiggle room to play around with. I might be able to put a little bit in the middle because it might be a little bit too wide, but we're going to see, okay? So, like I said, this first go around, I'm not trying to go for perfection with my subsections, but I am trying to get it to where it is controlled. And then one, as I go in and I begin to roll, I can fine-tune those subsections. And here's this side over here. She's looking a little wide, looking a little wide. I got a little greedy over here. So I'm going to take off some of this. I'm just going to come in here. What I like for you guys to do or encourage you guys to do is come down here and check the bottom and see. And then you can come in here in this middle area and kind of see it's a little bit wide. So I'm just going to chop a little bit of it off. Okay. And once again, it's like a slight curve, like a little C. And I'll let y'all take a look at that. Okay, can you see that? Okay, and I'm going to add this excess hair back with this piece right here. Okay, clip this baby out the way, and we're going to move on to the other side. Turn it around and around and around. All right. Now let's cover this other side. So we have one section. Ew, wait, she fell down. It's all right. It's still sectioned off. It's all good. All right. So she ain't got that much hair. So we are just going to clip that right there. All right. Now let's turn it. So we have one section, two sections, three sections down the center. Okay. Four, one at the top. Let me make this a little bit better for y'all to see. And now we have these last two sides that we're going to do over here. And we're going to continue with the same thing that we were doing. Take our roller. And we are going to measure this side over here. Okay. So I'm going to take my roller, place it here. And I'm going to, I see the length of it. Then I'm going to take my comb, place it right about right in this area right here. Try not to make it too wide. And then I'm going to follow it down from the top to the bottom behind the ear. And once again, I'm gonna double check once I divide this area off. She leaned a little bit to the left a little bit, and I can work on that and fix that in a minute. But I think this is gonna be good enough. So I like to pull it in a little ponytail so that I can see how wide that subsection truly is. So if you take a look at it right here, I pull in a little ponytail so I can see from here to here how wide it really is. So let's check it out with the roller. It's cute that I'm saying it, but let's confirm with this roller. It's a little wide, okay? So you can see here, it's a little wide. So I'm going to take slither a little bit off and push it back. That's basically how you fix your subsections. Miss Jenna's neck is tight. And granted, you can use the tip or you can use the teeth up here. Either one is correct. Depends on how I feel. Depends on how much control I need to have. All right, all right. We're getting there, y'all. All right, I think that's good enough. So I'm going to go ahead on and get this sectioned off so we can get rolling. You know what I need. All right, last section right here. And I hate, I'm sorry, I'm all up in the mix. I'm all up in the way. Okay. Tripod. I'm going to take a little bit off up here. It's a little bit too far to the left. Okay, so I'm gonna clean it up a little bit. So these are just some things that you can do as you're working to kind of clean up your work. Like I said, at the very first time I went in and did my mohawk section down the middle, I wasn't looking for perfection. I was just trying to kind of get a somewhat balance of how wide that subsection. And now I'm kind of cleaning up my work so I don't run into too many issues when I'm rolling. Okay. So we are about to start down the center, and we're going to go ahead and start rolling. So, I know you saw at the beginning I used a little bit of product. The product, you don't want to keep putting a whole bunch of like the actual product itself, because sometimes it can start making the hair get sticky. It can make it have like a nasty feel to it. So, I'm going to use my water bottle to kind of continue to enhance or to dampen the hair, to control it around the roller, okay? So as it begins to dry, I'm going to go to my product last resort, because I pretty much put the amount and I established the amount that I wanted to use throughout my set. Now, depending on your client If your client wants like a firm hold, then that's going to determine what type of product you decide to use, okay? But once again, my client, she doesn't really want a firm hold. We want more of a little flexible hold. But homegirl is going to have a lot of tight curls with these little tiny bros we're going to use today. Now, what y'all did learn was that when you are, so I have created 6 sections. This middle part right here, these two, the middle part divided into to 2 sections really don't have any significance. It's just more so for control. So I'm going to go ahead and comb these two together as I work now. I'm going to work from the top to the back, and then I'm going to work my sides down. So like I said, this is a standard set, something that your clients, your more seasoned or your more mature clients might decide, who kind of wear their hair going back and kind of downward. This might be the way you would do this particular type. You might decide to choose this particular type of set for that client. But there is a lot of variety you can do. But today, once again, we're going to use that standard. So when we're doing the center part, when we're going to get started with putting the rollers in, we created 6 sections. Now we're going to go in and create what we call a subsection. So I'm going to use the width. We use the length to establish how wide to make our subsections. Now I'm going to go in and use the width, this little round part, how wide that roller is to determine how wide my subsection need to be. So no matter what tool you're using, your subsection will be basically how wide that tool is, whether it be a foil, whether it be a curling iron, whether it's a flat iron, whatever you're using, your round brush, that subsection is generally the size of that tool that you're using. The size we're using is probably about 1 inch right here. I'm using my finger to gauge that, and I'm going to come in here and place that guy. And when you're working with your mannequin, come to the front, okay? When you go to establish how wide, place that baby right at that little, it marks the peak, okay? And then take your comb and just drag it slightly. So it will come right in here. This is how wide it will be. Okay? So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to place it here. Put my comb behind here. And allow it to bump right up against the back. And I'm going to place my finger right here so that I can divide it. And I'm going to drag it up, pinch it, bring this hair and separate it. Okay? Drag this hair back. Okay? And I'm going to bring it. So it depends on what, you know, you guys talked about quite a few different bases yesterday. You talked about the on base, you talked about half base, and then you talked about off base. I'm going to do on base, which means Miss Janice is going to have a lot of, it's going to have a lot of volume and a lot of curls. Shame on Miss Ava. So here we go. Bring her back this way so you guys can see me. I'm going to take this guy, comb this hair forward, take my roller, place it behind because the hair is going to come towards me. I want to roll it towards me like it's going to go towards the floor, so it's going back. And I'm going to come all the way to the end. And sometimes I'll take my comb and kind of smooth it towards the end, and then I'm going to roll that baby lap in. Here we go, and roll. All right, so first roll in. You're going to take your clip, and you're going to place your clip, one, the top part, and these are your sliding clips. One is going to go on the top of the roller, and one is going to dig in at the scalp and go in at the base, okay? Next roller. I'm going to place it up at that part. I'm going to come in here and measure behind it. Bring my finger over to the other side. And we are doing on base. Drag it forward. Smooth this hair. Use my comb. And get to rolling, 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 rolling. Get to rolling. I really need some music. Okay. Get my next one. And we're going to continue this same method. Place that roller up there at that part. And we can use a little bit more hair. Boy, Miss Janet's going to have some volume. And my roller ain't that big, so she's not gonna have a whole bunch of volume, but she gonna have some. Okay, so this is for that on basis for that client who, you know, really wants some poof going on at the base. But like I said, this is just my tool of choice. You don't have to use a rat tail. A rat tail seems to, for me, it does really good parting for me. Comb that hair forward. Bring it in. Ooh. Don't do me like that. Well, let me be great today, but that's all good. All right, here we go. Bring that hair in for control. Controlling is the big thing. I guess when it comes down to it, you really just want to make sure that the hair is smooth, because one thing with rollers and with anything is once you, if the hair ain't smooth, your work is not going to be polished at the end, okay? So that's what we're going for, polished look. All right, keep on going. And so I kind of can tell now about how wide my roller is. So I'm going to keep on, hey baby. I'm going to keep on going. Alright. Now, you are more than welcome. It depends on your consultation with your client. You very well might decide to change your base placement today. And so, and once again, whenever you're doing like on base and you're trying to create volume, usually people want volume at the crown area. They might want volume. Sometimes people like hair big on the sides. I mean, that's your consultation with your client. So if that's what you and your client discuss, then boom, make it happen, Captain. Give them what they want. Give them what they want. That big hair don't care. Big sexy hair, okay? So that's what Miss Jen's going for, because she got things to do this weekend, okay? And one of them is look cute with some big hair. So we're going to give her some big hair, okay? Now, we ask ourselves, because your clients are going to come in, and you're going to have to make the decision on what type of service you're going to give them. Do I do something like a wet set? Do I do a dry style? One thing about hair, and I mentioned a little bit in class the other day, that, you know, some people talk about hair memory and all of that stuff. There's a science to hair. That's just all it comes down to. It really ain't about memory. It's about science. You have bonds, okay? And one of those bonds, the job is that when you put water on it, it will break that bond. When it dries back, it will reshape into that new shape, okay? So when we think about the hydrogen bonds, the hair is wet now, okay? And the hair is straight. But now I'm going in and I'm putting this roller in this hair, okay? When it dries, it's going to dry. Those hydrogen bonds are going to dry into a new position, okay? It's not going to remember it. It's just going to do what it does. It's going to reform back into this curly position, okay? When water hits it, it's going to go back into its straight position. So that's the science of hair. We think about the different types of the different parts of the hair. We think about the bonds in the hair. Those bonds, they have a purpose, and that's what's going to happen to them as we have this water in the hair. So if I need some type of firm curl for my client, that's when we might decide. My client says, honey, I need these curls to last like 2 weeks. Okay, I need them to last till Sunday when I go to church on Sunday. So whatever the reason, okay, whatever the rhyme or the reason why your client wants this to last, then your go-to will be the roller set. But if your client just wants something soft and they want, you know, a few curls in their hair, but they don't want that commitment of that curl being all firm and tight for 2 weeks, they just want it to start to loosen up, then you might decide for that client to do, you know, thermal curls. So you have to establish that type of at the beginning when you are having your consultation with your client, which we're going to get more into next week, okay? But right now, we're trying to teach y'all a little something. And one of those things is how to roll this hair. So that's why we would choose a roller set for a client if that client needed that style of those curls to last and sit for a longer period of time. If that client also has, like, fine hair, and their hair really doesn't hold curl a lot, then you might decide, you might opt to do a roller set as well. You're going to find out that when you do a chemical wave on your clients, when your clients come in for perms, after you do the perm, they might ask you, can you know, the end style would be a roller set. The only reason why they might get that perm is to ensure that hair is going to hold, because maybe their hair doesn't hold curl a lot. So they decide, okay, baby girl, give me a perm, okay? That's why you're giving them the perm, but the whole goal is for their hair to be, you know, basically in a roller set style. And that roller set will last for them for 2 weeks. So when they go to church on Sunday or do what they do on Sundays, maybe they go walk their dog on Sunday and want to look cute. Who knows? But whatever the reason is, Miss Virginia's is getting a roller set, okay? And you're going to give it to her. And you're going to make her look fly. You're going to make her look good, okay? Give your client what they want, okay? All right, and so we're just going to keep this going on down from the top to the back. I'm changing up my size a little bit because I told you that Miss Janet's curls going to be tight today, okay? I already told y'all that, so just don't be, when I finish and when it's dry, I don't want to hear no noise. I don't want nobody looking at me funny like, why she do those tight curls? Because I told y'all Miss Janet wants tight curls today, so we're going to give her what she wants, all right? So I'm going even tighter. Her hair's a little bit shorter in the nape. Down here, this bottom part, her hair's a little bit shorter. So I'm going to go ahead and switch over to my yellow rods. Now, as I'm rolling, I can feel my ends are a little bit kind of slipping out of my roller. So I'm just going to take me a little bit of setting lotion, this styling foam, and I'm just going to add a little bit more to her ends for a little bit more control. Miss Janice, don't make me look bad when I get ready to style your hair. Please don't. All right, last two rollers. Well, at least down the center, not the whole thing. All right, we're getting there. We are getting there. We are getting there. Y'all, we need some music. I haven't told y'all that now. Love me some music. Oh, so I need an orange one, and I think I have one in the mix. So this is kind of like a peachy looking roller. Don't do me like that, bro. Alright, so I'm having some problems. So I'm going to take, you see how the bottom right here keeps sticking out with her coarse hair? I'm going to come in here and I'm going to take my comb and just help me out a little bit and roll it in so as I turn, I don't end up what we call fish hooks. So it doesn't look frizzy on the ends and end up not rolling up all the way how I need it. I tell y'all, music, baby. Back here, I already see I have my subsection, so I'm using this roller back here for my subsection. Y'all don't need to measure. I got something right there to you. Once again, I'm using this roller right here that I already have the subsection size, the width of it. I'm just using that for my measurement so I don't have to keep going in here with my roller. I hang it up in it, so I ain't gonna start it. But if you are left-handed, you would be coming from this side and going in and pulling out, okay? But I'm right-handed, so that's what I'm doing. Hey. And we switched. Now I'm on my yellow roller. On my yellow roller. Now, I'm getting to a little tiny, little small area. I could very well go in with these little small, tiny little rollers here. So if you take a look here, look how narrow this area is. I could use a narrow roller for it, okay? That's what these little babies are for. Hey, hey. I am. So I'm going with a large one. Just for being on the safe side. And that bottom one, I'm going to use one. If you do what I just did, let the extra excess roller hang out to the side. Well, drag and pull. Drag and pull. Alright, last piece down here at the bottom. Now for sure, for sure. Okay? I'm really, really going to use that small narrow roller, but I need a little bit more product, okay? Trying to give me problems. Oh, that would be great. Hey! Come on, baby. Don't put me like you. I don't see thee. All right, look, the music cool, but I needed something a little bit hyper. So give me a minute. I'm gonna be back in 1 second. All right, hold up.
Got a motive, and I think Whoa. All
right, these are the good ones.
Full firm.
Bring it down just a little bit because I don't want it so big on the side. And we just gonna do the same thing on the other side. If you're left-handed, you're going down. If you're right-handed, you're coming up. DJ real fast. Yeah, go right ahead.
With scam protection built into its core. Introducing Scam Shield Free.
Last section. Goodness, right here. The other side ain't no different from the rest. Just the same thing, brown the whole head. My playlist is a little whack today, but it is what it is. Hey. A little slower. Now take a look here. If you look at the way the head tilts, well, let me bring her head up so you can really see what I'm talking about. Parallel. So if I take this guy. And take it easy. Alright, take a look at me. So take a look right here. that's where my roller is going to sit, but it's going to tilt. It's going to be parallel. So when you look at the hat, the scalp, that slant, that's exactly where your roller is going to lay in the exact same way, okay? You always follow in the head. So now, right here, it's almost like a little mountaintop almost, like that, okay? Now, as y'all can see, I had tan roller on the top on the other side. Try to stick with the same color for balance. Just slightly, just because I don't really need that big, that much volume on the side. Last one, guys. Just take my clip out just so it don't give me no problems later.
Sometimes getting closer to each other means getting farther away from your routine.
Hey, hey.
Okay. Because the best memories.
There we go. When so when you all done, this is what you should expect right here. Is this right here. So David.
And Frankie.
So when you look at it, just turn around and this is what you're looking for right here. Is the whole thing to be rolled. And it should look just like this right here. Yep. I'll take off the sand. And take it down and around. So if you take a look at the center, it's all going back. Okay. This is the back part. And we take a look at the sides. They're going down towards the floor. And this side is going down. Use the small roll at the bottom. Same thing on the sides here. Down. And down as well. Use the small one at the bottom. Now, baby girl, when you get dry,
Makata.
When she's all dry, we're going to be back to see the end result. See y'all soon. So guys, Miss Janice is under the dryer. She hasn't complained of how hot it is yet, but she's been under here for approximately about 20 minutes, and she's probably going to have about an additional 20 more minutes, if not more, depending on the length of her hair, depending on the density of her hair. So this is not a quick come out on your lunch break type of style. Miss Janice needs to make prior arrangements to make sure that she has enough time for this particular service when she's getting the roller set. This is not a drive-by service, Miss Janice. This is one that's going to take a little bit longer. So she's got to sit underneath the dryer when she gets this particular service done. So just make sure that if you decide to do a roller set for your client,
that your client has a sufficient amount of time to get the service done. So yeah, baby girl gonna be underneath this heat for a good 30 minutes to an hour. 30 minutes is like if you have really fine hair. But if she has thick, coarse, long hair, Miss Shannon's can be any underneath this dryer anywhere between 1 hour to 2 hours. Lord forbid. But needless to say, it's possible. So she's gonna chill here until she finishes getting dry, and then we're gonna take her out and hook her up with the style. All right, we'll be back later. Bye.